Welcome back. Today I'm going to talk about schizophrenia, a severe mental illness. My name is Dr.Deepak Kelkar. I'm psychiatrist, sexologist, hypnotherapist and de-addiction specialist practicing at Akola, Maharashtra. Schizophrenia is a mental disorder. It's a psychotic condition and it's a severe mental disorder. According to some studies, approximately 1% of the population is suffering from schizophrenia. It's a serious mental illness. Sometimes it is called as cancer of mind. The main symptoms which are there in schizophrenia are like patient has got thought disorder. Thought disorder in the form of he feels that somebody is inserting thoughts in his mind or thought broadcast. Like somebody, like his thoughts are being broadcasted out on television and people come to know about his thoughts. So it's a thought broadcast, thought insertion. Then some people have got delusions. So delusions like delusions of persecution that somebody is following him, somebody is doing harm to him, they are plotting against him, you know, or they are talking about him. So delusions of reference, delusions of paranoia, you know, so like paranoid delusions are there. Then some people have got hallucinations, like they listen to voices. Auditory hallucinations are most common, like people are talking about him, people are following him, they are coming to beat him, you know, and he listens to voices of people. They may be known people or unknown people. Then people, some patients, they have got incoherence of speech. Like what they are talking, you know, we can't understand what they are talking. This totally irrelevant talk. One sentence is not connected to another sentence. So they are irrelevant. Then some patients, they have got catatonia or catatonic symptoms in the form of excitement, violence. They start beating people, you know, they become very aggressive. They feel that somebody is against them and somebody is following them and somebody is talking about them and they become aggressive. Or some people are stuporous, like just not moving from a place. They are completely like person is like his staring look, he has got staring look, he has got rigidity or his posturing. Then some people, they have got emotional problems, like inappropriate emotions. They start laughing, they start crying without any reason. Or there is apathy. Apathy means like no emotions, flattened emotions, incongruent emotions, you know, so they are there. Then they are not functioning. They are not functioning at all. They withdraw themselves from the environment. They don't talk to much, like anyone much. They don't take care of their hygiene. They may be having cognitive disturbances in the form of they are not oriented at times, place and person, you know, or they are absorbed in their own world. And if these symptoms are there for at least 1 month continuously in last 6 months, then according to DSM-40R, the diagnosis is schizophrenia. Now the treatment is antipsychotic medications. They work well. There are older antipsychotics, there are newer antipsychotics. Older antipsychotics, they work faster. They are like the symptoms, they are brought under control very fast and very well, but they have got extrapyramidal symptoms, extrapyramidal reactions. So many psychiatrists, they prefer newer antipsychotics in the form of olanzapine, risperidone, aripiprazole, quetiapine. Now in last decade, clozapine is the drug which is called as a golden or the like golden treatment, you know, gold standard for treating schizophrenia. So that causes the like drug clozapine, you know, that is very powerful drug, but that causes blood dyscrasias or leukocytopenia, and then there is a lot of salivation, and because of that people don't prefer. Olanzapine, those who have got diabetes or higher blood sugar levels, we don't prefer olanzapine in them. Metabolically friendly antipsychotics are aripiprazole, quetiapine, and they work well. Now if the person doesn't become alright with these medicines and there is no improvement, then we have to go for electroconvulsive therapy, ECT, shock treatment. The patient doesn't know about the shock. How? Because we give anesthesia. Anesthesia is given, patient is anesthetized, and the current is passed from one temporal lobe to another, and after 3 to 4 sessions maybe the person becomes alright. There is no pain. So like patient doesn't know. So people, they have got false beliefs, you know, like blood will be dried due to ECT or due to electric shock, you know, patient will be weak, patient like there will be habit for the person to take shocks ongoingly for the whole time, for his whole lifetime. So like all these are false beliefs. People are not well informed. ECT is much safer and it must be given if the antipsychotics are not helpful. We should try antipsychotics for 6 to 8 weeks. We can change antipsychotics, give in combination, And if nothing works, then ECT is helpful. So if you like this video, please share this video. Thank you very much. Like and subscribe. Thank you.